Because it's so frustrating to see people that signed up for this experience to hold back and not step out of their comfort zone. It's like, that's the whole reason why you here. Welcome to La Vida Rosa. I'm your host, Pinky, and today I'm going to be reviewing Married at First Sight Season 9. Don't forget to check out LaVidaRosaStyle.com where you can find cute earrings like the ones I'm wearing right now. And more. The link is down below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And without further ado, let's get into this video. Okay, y'all, so when I first watched this episode, I was like, there's not that much going on. But then I watched it again and took notes, and I actually have like a good bit of notes. So I'm like, oh, maybe it was. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. So first I'm gonna talk about them all together, and then I'm gonna go to each individual couples. I love when all the couples come together and you can kind of see how they interact with one another in like a group setting. And like they said, they're the only ones going through that at that exact moment. So it's just nice to see them relate to each other, even though they might come from, you know, various different backgrounds. And one thing Iris pointed out in this episode that I didn't really pay attention to is that it seems like the women are very high energy and the men are like a little bit more on the chill side, you know? So it's cool to see how they balance each other out. So I'm gonna go ahead and get Matthew and Amber out of the way because there wasn't really too much to say about their segments. Their main storyline was that they consummated their marriage and it seems like they're closer than ever. And they just had a good time getting to know each other, working out together. They actually went on a tour of Antigua. That kind of made me want to go visit because it was so pretty. It looked amazing. And basically Amber was like, it feels so natural and easy to be with him. And she said she hopes it stays this easy. But we can see next episode that possibly they're going to have a little bit more, you know, I don't want to say trouble, but they're going to face some issues because Matthew plays basketball overseas. But that was just a preview, so we really don't even know what that's going to be. I can't wait to see that conversation next week. You know how they make things seem like it's such a huge deal, and then when they actually have the conversation, like they have the dramatic music, but it's literally still no big deal. So you just never. So I'm just going to move on to Keith and Iris. First of all, I just love their hair. I just think they're so cute together. Like, she has her fro, and let me just tell you, her various hairstyles during this trip proves that natural hair has to be the most versatile hair on this earth, because she had a fro, she did an updo, she did her little cute scarf, she did like her little twist around. It was just versatility. It was a different hairstyle every day, girl. And I was like, go ahead, because it was totally different than her hair from the wedding. So I'm like, versatility. Iris wanted to make sure she asked Keith what was his true intentions and does he plan on working to make this marriage work in the long run. And she, you know, she said later on that was a major concern of hers. And Keith basically told her he was, you know, in so many words. I mean, Keith be saying all the right things. And, you know, I want to root for him and her so bad because it seems like he's being patient and it seems like he really is trying. But, you know, people's patience wears thin. When it comes to waiting, sometimes men's patience is much shorter than what they think it is. Like, they think they can take on the challenge and they can't. And I'm not saying he's one of those people. I've personally been in this same position many times. To where the guy was like, yeah, of course, I respect it, I love it, da da da, but in the end they cannot. So I'm not saying that's the case with Keith because they're actually married, so I'm sure he's willing to put in a lot more effort. I just hope that he's prepared to deal with this situation because it's not gonna be easy. Like I said in the last review, I wish Iris could have been the first one to tell him that she was a virgin, because I would love to see his honest real reaction to her actually telling him than his mother, where he got to, you know, sit around and prepare an answer, because all of his answers sound really good, but I would love to see him like really on the spot, you know. Then they discuss things that their partner could work on improving already, and Iris said Keith be on his phone for too long. Not that he be on it all day, but when he finally does get on it, it's like he be glued to his phone. And I can understand that, because sometimes you just want to be like, hey, I'm here. You don't have to just be in your phone all the time, even though I feel like that would be me, possibly. And his thing with Iris is that she's a morning person, so I'm sure she wakes up bright and cheery. Hello, how are you doing? You want breakfast? You want to do this? And he's like, give me a couple 15-30 minutes to stir around, because I can feel that too, because I am not a morning person at all. Like, I need some time to wake up. I'm possibly angry that I've been woken up in the first place, so give me some time to get over that, and then we can, you know, once I brush my teeth, take a shower, eat a little something, I'm good. Then later on their trip, they went swimming with stingrays. He actually surprised her with it, which was great, because he didn't know, you know, whether she would like it or not, but it turns out she loved it. And then after that, they had a beautiful dinner, and during the dinner they talked about his parents being married for 30 years and how that has influenced him to want to be friends with someone and want his wife to be his best friend. And I feel like that's gonna be like a great example for them going forward. I mean, that's amazing. You don't see people being married for this long. Personally, at my church, most of the couples in my church, I feel like we have a great marriage rate, because the people that were married when I was a baby are still married today. I'm surrounded by people that have been married like 10, 20, 30 years. So, you know, it's just great to see a good example to show you it's possible. So next I'm going to move on to Jamie and Elizabeth, who had their first fight. But I feel like they handled it very well. I feel like they said, it was a miscommunication. So after the couples were split up and they met with, you know, the husbands over here, the wives over here, Elizabeth decided to go back to the hotel room and shower off because she got dirty from all the sand. I'm guessing because Elizabeth didn't immediately come find Jamie, he decided to go get lunch on his own, and he was gone for a good 2 hours. And so finally she got tired of waiting on him, and she went to get her own food. And so when she came back up, it was this big thing. Jamie is used to not feeling prioritized in a relationship, because in his past relationships, they didn't respect his feelings as much. That's what it seemed like. And so I also feel like he's still thinking from a single man's perspective. I just feel like it's gonna take a while for them to adjust to married life. But I also like that Elizabeth was able to express her feelings to him and for him to actually receive them. You know, at first he was being a little, you know, like, when I wasn't trying to, but then eventually he understood what she was saying, and he even expressed himself. I feel like they had excellent communication, and the problem was solved. He's just gonna know that, you know, you're my priority, and she's gonna say the same thing, and they're gonna put each other first. So just, I feel like a simple text message could have really solved that situation, to be honest. Like, it was very dramatic because, you know, Elizabeth is so out there and dramatic. It didn't have to be all that, but I'm glad they had that confrontation so they could, you know, you have to have some confrontation in order to communicate more effectively. I also like how later on in the episode they discuss not keeping score of what the other person does, because I think that's very important to do things for one another. And this is for any relationship, period. Like, for my friends, if I do something for my friend, I'm not going to keep score of everything I did for you. And if you don't do one thing for me, I'll be like, well, I did this. No, that's not how relationships should work. So I'm glad they discussed that. It's, you know, I hate when people try to throw things in your face, what they did for you, because I'd rather you not even do that at all if you're just gonna throw it in my face. And then they also discussed how neither one of them want to have kids, but they lied to the experts and told them that they wanted kids. And I'm like, yeah, that ended up turning out perfect. But see, that's how I feel like that's how sometimes these couples be getting screwed up, because you be lying. What if you got matched with somebody who really wanted kids bad? Like, on the other season, I forgot her name, but she had blonde hair. That was her main goal, was to have children. So what if either one of you got matched up with someone who, that's their main goal in life, is to have kids, but y'all sitting up here lying? Like, I'm glad it worked out, but that really, I'm like, see, I think half the time it's not the expert's fault. People be lying, or people don't be like forthcoming with their true feelings. But honestly, I don't see nothing wrong with either one of them not wanting kids. Like, some people just don't want to have kids, and I don't see a problem with that. It just makes me wonder, like, what's gonna happen to you when y'all get old though? Like, who gonna take care of you? Like, that's the only thing that kind of concerns me. But other than that, like, do you? I don't care. I want kids, but if y'all don't, it don't matter.
Okay,
Gregory and Deanna. So at the beginning of the episode, Deanna is letting Gregory know, you're like showering me with compliments, and stop complimenting me. And you know, at first I was like, girl, he just like you. You know, let this man compliment you. But I got where she was coming from. She doesn't mind the compliments, just not 2 and 3 and 4 in a row. Because I've been in that situation where it's like constant compliments. It's like, thank you, thank you, thank you. How many times do I have to say thank you? How many times do I have to compliment you back? Like, all right, thank you, let's move on. Definitely you should compliment your woman every day, but not 2 and 3 times in a row, because that can be a little awkward. I don't know. The more and more I see them, the more I see the connection growing. Deanna does come off as a little standoffish, but I see her making an effort. I see her trying to hold his hand and trying to, like, snuggle up closer. And at first, I was scared of them falling into the friend zone, but I see her making an effort. And he even expressed his concerns with her. And he's just scared that she's gonna remain independent because she's had to be that way for so long. And she vowed that she would not clam up, she would open up, and she would do her best to try to, you know, break the walls down. And I feel like she's been making a decent effort. Like, in past seasons when there has been, you know, some sort of tension where the woman is, you know, has her walls up, I feel like they didn't really make a genuine effort to try. They were looking for, maybe they weren't attracted to the other person, or maybe they just, you know, just weren't, I don't know. It's just like they just didn't care to step outside of their comfort zone. And I feel like Deanna is, like, she's genuinely trying, and that's all anybody could ask for. And I feel like Gregory is grateful for that. It just seems like he's not gonna, you know, just let her go easily. He's gonna do everything he can, and however long it takes, to get into her heart. And it is so cute. And they went ziplining for their little excursion. I would have been Deanna. Like, she was so excited, like, yay. Gregory was scared. He, you know, heights, that's a fear for some people. But what I liked about him is that he actually made the effort. Once again, I feel like for them, they do a lot of compromising already. Like, they give when it's not comfortable for them. And I'm like, yes, that's what we want on this show. Because it's so frustrating to see people that signed up for this experience to hold back and not step out of their comfort zone. It's like, that's the whole reason why you here. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I really love this series. Like I said, I've been watching since pretty much the beginning, and I love reviewing it too, because I love to hear y'all's opinions. So let me know what y'all think down below, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Peace.